Hello students, in the last class we discussed single phase, full wave, AC voltage controller with resistive load. Today we will discuss single phase, full wave, AC voltage controller with RL load. The circuit diagram is shown here. It consists of supply voltage Vs is equal to Vm sin omega t, two SCRs T1 and T2 are connected in anti-parallel and RL load. Also, we know that during the positive half cycle, T1 is forward biased and during the negative half cycle, T2 is forward biased. Therefore, we are giving firing pulses to T1 during the positive half cycle and we are giving firing pulses to T2 during the negative half cycle. Here, consider the firing angle alpha is equal to 90 degree. So, this one is the supply voltage waveform. Consider the positive half cycle. During 0 to pi, T1 is forward biased. At omega t is equal to alpha, which is equal to 90 degree, T1 is triggered and current flows through the path Vs, T1, load back to the source. So, the output voltage V0 is this one, positive Vs. At omega t is equal to pi, source voltage and load voltage are 0. But the output current I0 is not 0 because of the presence of inductance in the load. Therefore, the output voltage goes negative and continue till omega t is equal to beta, where beta is the extinction angle. At omega t is equal to beta, energy stored in the inductor is released and T1 is turned off. So, consider the output current waveform. From alpha to pi, current increases and from pi to beta, energy stored in the inductor is released and current gradually reduces to 0 at omega t is equal to beta. So, at omega t is equal to beta, the I0 is 0 and the thyristor T1 is turned off. From beta to pi plus alpha, both T1 and T2 are in the off state. Therefore, the output voltage is 0. We know that during the negative half cycle, thyristor T2 is forward biased. Here minus, here plus. At omega t is equal to pi plus alpha, firing pulses are given to T2 and current flows through the path positive load T2 back to the source. So, the output voltage is minus Vs. This voltage appears across the load. So, during this interval, the output current gradually increases in the negative direction. At omega t is equal to 2 pi, both supply voltage and output voltage are 0, but the output current I0 is not equal to 0 because of the presence of inductance. Therefore, the output voltage goes positive and continue till the load current decreases to 0. Means when the energy stored in the inductor is released. Again at omega t is equal to 2 pi plus alpha, T1 is turned on and so on. So these are the output voltage and output current waveforms. Next is the voltage across the thyristor T1, VT1. From the output voltage waveform, it is clear that from 0 to this point, one of the SCR is in the on state and both are connected in parallel. Therefore, the voltage across the switches T1 and T2 are 0. From here to alpha, both SCRs are in the off state. Therefore, this voltage, this portion, appears across the switch T1. So VT1 is this one, this voltage. Similarly, from alpha to beta, one of the SCR is in the on state. So it acts as short circuit. Therefore, the voltage across the switches T1 and T2 are 0. From beta to pi plus alpha, here, both the SCRs are in the off state. Therefore, this voltage appears across the switch T1. So this one is the voltage across the switch T1. Next, we will draw the voltage across the switch T2. We know that VT2 is equal to minus VT1 because both are connected in anti-parallel. So this one is the voltage across the thyristor T2. VT1 is equal to minus VT2. Thank you.